Today's topic for discussion is Acial stage of Puccinia graminis form species TTC. Puccinia graminis causes wheat rust disease and it is a polymorphic fungus. That means it produces 5 different types of spores during its life cycle. And acial stage, it is one of the stage which is characterized by a formation of aciospores. These aciospores are produced in an acial cup or a cluster cup on the lower epidermis of barberry leaf. Barberry, it is the secondary host of Puccinia graminis. And before the formation of acial cup, spermatization takes place. During spermatization, fusion of spermatium and receptive hyphae takes place. Spermatization is brought about through the agency of insects. Insects are attracted by the fragrance of spermogonial mass while the insects are sucking the sweet nectar, releasing from the ostiole. Spermatia stick to the legs or mouth parts when the insects visit other spermogonia. Spermatia become attached to the receptive hypha. Spermatization takes place when positive strain comes with contact with the negative strain or vice versa. The spermatial nucleus passes into the receptive hypha by a pore formed at the point of contact. Meanwhile, a primary mycelium within the barberry leaf produces a number of acial primordia. And acial primordia are developed towards the lower epidermis. The spermatia reach the protoacia or primordia passing through the septal perforations of the mycelium and render their cells binucleate, thus bringing about dikaryotization. The acial primordia fail to develop further if spermatization fails. After dikaryotization, acial primordia or protoacia further grow and form acial cups in the on the lower surface of the barberry in which aciospores are developed. Dikaryotic mycelium soon becomes surrounded by a pseudoparenchymatous structure that is made up of mycelium, and the mycelium produces vertically elongated cells which are called hymenium, or that layer is known as hymenium. Hymenium is the fertile layer of the mycelium of Puccinia graminis. Each cell of hymenium divides transversely and produces a long chain of aciospores. Aciospores are produced in basipetalous succession and are separated from one another by small sterile cell which is called disjunctor cell, or it is also called as intercalary cell. Acial cup at this stage shows an outer wall called peridium. This is made up of fungal hyphae, and at maturity peridium ruptures due to the pressure created inside the formation of aciospores. The sterile cells or disjunctor cells degenerate and aciospores becomes free. Each aciospore is spherical, dikaryotic, 2 nuclei present in that, and it has 2 layers. The outer wall is known as exine, inner wall is known as intine, and it has many germ pores. Aciospores produced on barberry plant are unable to infect the barberry plant. Instead of that, they infect the primary host, that is wheat plant. Aciospores germinate to form a cylinder branched germ tube which comes out through the germ pore. Germ tube enters into the host through the stoma or stomata. By its further growth, it produces profusely branched dikaryotic mycelium into the leaf of wheat, and which forms uridospores that produces uridospores and tillitospores the usual way. Okay, Puccinia graminis is thus a highly polymorphic fungus producing several types of spores, that is basidiospores, spermatia, aciospores, uridospores and tillitospores. Of these 5 different types of spores, uridospores Young teletospores and acospores are binucleate, whereas basidiospores and spermatia are uninucleate. Further, eudospores and teletospores are produced on the primary host wheat plant, and basidiospores are found in the soil. Spermatia and acospores, spermatia or pycnospores, and acospores are found on the alternate host, that is barberry. This is all about acial stage of Vaccinia graminis, which causes rust disease of wheat. Thank you very much. Save trees, save earth.